Hachette Audio presents an RDA audio production of Loopholes of Real Estate, written and read by Garrett Sutton, Esquire.
Preface and Acknowledgements. The genesis of this book begins with Real Estate Loopholes, which was first released in January 2003 and was on the bestseller list that summer. Then, with additional information on landlord liability, insurance, and other legal and tax issues included, it was published as Real Estate Advantages in 2006. Of note, in his foreword to that edition, Robert Kiyosaki called the real estate bubble. After the bubble burst, there were many new issues for real estate investors to consider, including the importance of clear title in the wake of record foreclosures. So we have brought in new and updated material, including a chapter that questions the utility of land trusts, as well as new changes in the laws of asset protection. Fair warning, some of the chapters contain the same information as the previous editions. This is because, with all due modesty, there's no reason to redo what was brilliantly brought forth the first time. But there are many new sections as well. We have incorporated up-to-date sections written by CPA and Rich Dad Advisor Tom Wheelwright on cost segregations, using IRAs for investing, and becoming a real estate professional. We have updated Gary Gorman's chapter on 1031 exchanges from 7 years ago. And in this edition, and the reason we now call it Loopholes of Real Estate, we explore the medieval history of loopholes. I find it fascinating, and it only took me a decade to tie it together. For this new edition, I would like to thank Robert Kiyosaki, Tom Wheelwright, Gary Gorman, Brandy McLeod, Mona Gambetta, Jessica Santina, Ken McElroy, and Kathy Spitzer for all your valuable contributions. They are greatly appreciated.
Foreword by Robert Kiyosaki. Read by Steve Stratton. Before I began my business career, my rich dad insisted that I learn to be a real estate investor. At first, I thought he wanted me to invest in real estate simply for the real estate itself. As the years went on and my base of education grew, I came to better understand the bigger picture of the world of investing. Rich Dad said, "If you want to be a sophisticated investor, you must train your mind to see what your eyes cannot see." What my eyes could not see were the legal and tax advantages that real estate investing offers the more informed investor. In other words, there is far more to real estate than dirt, sticks, and bricks. This book, written by Garrett Sutton, one of our Rich Dad advisors, goes into the real reasons why the rich invest in real estate. Loopholes of Real Estate will take you into the world of real estate investing that the average investor rarely sees. Today, I make my money from all three asset classes, businesses, real estate, and paper assets, but I hold the bulk of my wealth in real estate. I'm able to magnify my wealth using the advantages that real estate offers the sophisticated investor. There have been challenges for real estate investors in the recent past, but if you learn the ins and outs of real estate investing, you can make money in real estate whether the market is going up, down, or sideways. That's why my rich dad preferred investing for cash flow instead of capital gains. As long as your property is cash flow positive, you can ride out a downturn in the real estate market. The flippers and capital gains buyers who are left holding properties for resale in a plummeting market are the ones who will be hurt the most. You also need to surround yourself with good advisors. As a real estate investor, you must seek tax and legal advice from professionals, which is why Garrett wrote this book. I do not know all the details of the tax and legal advantages he describes, but I am glad that he, as my advisor, does. If you're ready to become a sophisticated investor, find out how to use tax, legal, and other little-known advantages that investing in real estate offers, and how to find your own team of advisors, this book is for you.
Part 1. Real Estate Advantages. Do you want to know a secret? Do you want to know the loopholes that allow successful real estate investors to do it so well? You don't have to be a genius to understand and apply these loopholes. You just have to be willing to follow a proven path toward success. Basically, you need to be smart about following what others have used to their advantage before you. The truth is, there are two types of real estate loopholes. From a tax standpoint, there are real estate loopholes to be opened. The tax code, as put forth by Congress and the IRS, encourages certain real estate activities. Smart investors know how to open these loopholes to their maximum advantage. From the legal side, there are real estate loopholes to be closed. There is liability and risk associated with owning real estate, leading to loopholes of increased personal liability and responsibility for the claims of others. These legal loopholes must be closed in order to gain asset protection and best protect yourself and your family. How can I learn these secrets, you ask, and how can I apply them? The secrets of real estate loopholes are not handwritten on aged parchment, locked in a dark and inaccessible vault in the depths of a well-fortified castle, and guarded by huge rabid dogs, fed by the rich and powerful, as a way to exclude all newcomers. On the contrary, although not set out everywhere, the important loophole strategies, the ones you must know, are found in this audiobook. In using these loopholes, you have to be willing to combine the experience of others with the specifics of your own situation. This is not hard to do. In all aspects of our lives, we synthesize and apply information. But unlike most other activities, by learning when to open loopholes and when to close them, you are going to significantly improve your results as a real estate investor. And in applying these loopholes, you will become smart about selecting real estate, as we will review in the final section of this audiobook. Let's begin by answering several interesting questions. Introduction. What are the advantages of real estate? Does the government care if you own real estate? Not really. Does the government offer significant advantages if you do own real estate? Absolutely. But aren't there risks that limit the benefits of owning real estate? Perhaps. Have the rich figured out ways to minimize that risk to their advantage? Of course, and so can you. Real estate offers huge financial advantages to those who will learn the system. And as this audiobook will illustrate, any risks can efficiently be managed through insurance, legal structures, and other common strategies that are neither difficult nor expensive. There are great advantages to investing in real estate, both as a cash flow business and as a wealth builder. And the financial benefits flow from several sources, including the appreciation of your land and property values and the monthly cash flow you can earn by renting out residential, office, or commercial space in a structure on your land. In addition, you stand to benefit greatly through tax reduction from depreciation on those structures and through options to roll over profits as allowed in the tax code. You can even benefit from writing off business expenses associated with your investment. And because of these advantages, it is easier to raise capital for real estate ventures. Real estate investors can accelerate their wealth building much faster than with other assets, such as stocks, bonds, and tax-deferred retirement funds. Our financial, tax, and legal systems are set up to reward property owners who are educated enough to seize the available advantages. And best of all, for starting investors, they don't need enormous cash reserves to buy real estate. They can start small. Like first-time home buyers, real estate investors can secure bank loans and make monthly payments as owners of rental property. And as they watch their equity grow, they can parlay their initial investment property's increased value into garnering a new loan to purchase a second property. Pulling this cash out has a second benefit in that they do not have to pay taxes on the money they receive because it is from their equity, and so on. They can learn as they go, perhaps making some mistakes and increasing their knowledge through experience as their holdings expand. The financial, tax, and legal advantages, as spelled out in this audiobook, of owning real estate are enormous. And the question you, the listener, may ask is, why don't more investors follow this route to success? The answer is twofold and simple: lack of knowledge and fear. Begin your education now. Many investors who avoid real estate are afraid of the anticipated difficulties of being landlords. They hear the horror stories. They think to themselves, I don't want to fix toilets, and I don't want to get calls from tenants in the middle of the night. But know that there are strategies for intelligently managing a property that any capable person can implement. As well, many people fear the threat of a lawsuit, and rightly so. We are a litigious society. Attorneys are rewarded for bringing claims against wealthy individuals. But know that there are asset protection strategies we'll listen to that can reduce your exposure and limit your liability. In all, the rewards of owning real estate far outweigh the drawbacks for most prudent investors. In recent years, many have come to fear the entire market. With the meltdown in 2008, thousands of real estate investors were caught with properties worth less than the mortgage on the parcel. These underwater properties have caused a great deal of turmoil for many investors. Some will never re-enter the real estate market. But others, who do not fear but rather appreciate the market, will do well. For in any environment, there is room to make money in real estate. Similarly, when it comes to lack of knowledge, most people are unaware of the advantages to be gained from investing in real estate. This is understandable. Most of us in our society aren't raised to consider investing in real estate. It's certainly not taught in schools. The standard pattern is to go to school, get a job, climb up the corporate ladder of a career, put earnings in a bank, maybe buy stocks, mutual funds, and bonds, and save for a rainy day, including retirement. Most of us don't realize that real estate investments allow our money to accelerate at a greater pace than typical paper investments. In fact, real estate has historically, over the long term, trended up in value and yielded higher returns than the securities markets. There are really three types of income. Earned income. This is what you bring home from work in the form of a paycheck. You go to the office from 8 to 5. If you stop going to work, your earned income would end. Passive income. This is what comes to you from an investment such as real estate. If you get sick and can't earn a paycheck from your job, your real estate is still working for you. Even better, most of this income may not be subject to Social Security and Medicare withholdings, and in some cases, incurs no tax at all because of your ability to depreciate a property's value or to defer claimed gains by rolling over a sale to another property. Portfolio income. This is what comes from the dividends and increases in value of paper assets, such as stocks, bonds, and mutual funds. It's the most popular form of investment income for the masses because it's easier to manage than real estate and other investments. The point of this audiobook isn't to encourage you to invest only in real estate. The rich dad philosophy is to diversify, although in a different sense of the word as used by financial planners, and to put your savings and earnings into three different areas: business, real estate, and paper assets. This is because each sector is subject to market fluctuations and corrections, and your investment risk must be spread out. The point of this audiobook is to explain the financial, tax, and legal advantages of investing in real estate as a passive income earner, and to educate you on how to utilize these investment advantages. If this is your first Rich Dad book, please know that Rich Dad's philosophy is that your primary residence should not be considered an asset because it is not generating regular income for you. Rich Dad has a simple definition for asset, something that puts money in your pocket. A liability, conversely, is something that takes money from your pocket. With your primary residence, you're paying the mortgage, and therefore the cash flow is going from you to the bank, not toward you. Your home mortgage is an example of bad debt.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.